Hello, hello. My name is Carl Jones. I am a cinematographer and photographer based in London. And today we're going to be talking about saving money, I guess. Now, if you're at all into buying old camera equipment and photography and that kind of stuff, then you've definitely fallen victim to, like every other photographer, going through eBay, going through Facebook Marketplace, because I can definitely refinance and remortgage and sell everything for two pieces of glass that will definitely make all my work look better. But if you're also like me, then you're also very keen to find out what the really cheap lenses are like. For the longest time, shooting on vintage lenses has been used in cinema. People really enjoy shooting on because of the cinematic texture that they bring and the different feel that they have and all those kind of things that anyone that's not in the film industry does not notice. But we care. We care what it looks like. So that's why we're here. That's why we're here, to try and find lenses that are not going to make me want to, you know, take a six-figure loan out. Instead, we want to find lenses that have been left in the bottom of someone's garage in a box, that are somehow still in good condition and aren't full of mold, that someone is selling on Facebook Marketplace or on eBay for less than three figures. And I've been on this journey for a very long time. I've been on this journey since I was in university. I've been on this journey since before I was at university. Oh, I've been on this journey for so long that I have recently decided that I want to try and share some of the knowledge that I've come across and, you know, just like give myself a reason to buy more lenses off of eBay. But a set of lenses that I've had for a very long time that I swear by and I love, and a set of lenses that I find not a lot of people know about, is why we're here today. And that is the Nikon Series E lenses. The Nikon E Series lenses are Nikon's economical line of lenses. They were designed to make photography more affordable and to get people into, you know, taking photos and, more importantly, buying Nikon equipment. And what that means is you have a manufacturer that's known for some of the cleanest and sharpest glass on the market at the time, making lenses that they are gonna have to cut corners on because, you know, they want to make them cheaper. And that results in glass that has a little bit of funk and a little bit of character to it, and isn't as sharp and isn't as clean, and because of that is very interesting, or at least I think is very interesting. Some people might think it's a pile of fucking shit, but I think it's really cool. So the line consists of quite a lot of different lenses, but we're going to focus primarily on the four primes, which are the 28 f/2.8, the 35 f/2.5, the 50 f/1.8, and the 100mm f/2.8. In regards to the build quality and the style of these lenses, they are made of plastic. The AI and the AIS lenses are made of metal. They're heavy, they're high quality, they're heavy duty. Whereas the E-series lenses, because they wanted them to be cheaper, are made of plastic. You know, they're not going to take the biggest knock and the biggest hit. But then again, saying that, I'm able to carry four primes and my camera on a walk around, and it's not that big of a deal. I find that they can be quite difficult to work around on a more professional setting. At the end of the day, they are cheaper, smaller, plasticky vintage lenses, but with a little bit of workaround, they are usable and they give some incredible imagery. In regards to that as well, you also have the size. They have managed to make all of these lenses tiny. And with the build quality and the optics being not as high as their other sets of lenses, that then leads you to the cost of them. These lenses are not expensive. I've had these lenses for 7 or 8 years and the price hasn't shifted on them the whole time I've had them. And especially the 50 f/1.8, you can get for around £50. And it's also the lens I've owned the longest for the set. I've sold it, I've rebought it. It is safe to say that that lens is one of my favorite lenses of all time. And that leads me onto my final point, which is the quality of these lenses. They are so nice for the money. To be able to pick up four lenses of the same character and the same quality for under £400, but all of those lenses, you know, stopped down, are razor sharp, but then you can open them up and they start to bloom and they start to have these characteristics that you would try and traditionally get rid of, but give such a, you know, filmic feel to whatever you're filming. It's really hard to not love them. And I can understand that some people aren't looking for the like messier characteristics. Some people want their lenses to be sharp, but if you're looking for something that's a bit dreamy and has some quite textured bokeh and has chromatic aberration, but not enough that it's sort of overpowering the image, but you know it's there, these lenses are the one. Since picking up the XH2-S about 2 or 3 months ago, I have shot exclusively on the 35mm for this. Being able to have four of these lenses in a camera bag as sort of like a bit more of an everyday carry, when you know you're sort of like going for a day out and you want to capture some photo and you want to capture some video, but you don't want to take everything, you don't want to take anything super big, but you want that quality and you want that style, then these are the lenses. I need some tea. Bet you loved that. Cool. So, who are these lenses perfect for? That's a great question. I think these lenses are perfect for anyone who is looking for lightweight, travel-friendly primes. They're sharp, but they have quite a lot of character, and they are so small. You know that you're going to get a really high-quality image. You know that you're going to get something that's got some character and that is sharp, but you are also getting the addition of it being extremely low profile. Now, you're not going to get autofocus, you're not going to get the cleanest image, you're not going to get the shallowest image, but what you are going to get is something that isn't going to break your bag, isn't going to break your back, and isn't going to break your bank account. They're wonderful. They're wonderful pieces of glass, and I could not recommend them more. So, that is all I have to say about the Nikon E Series lenses. Let me know if this was useful to you. Otherwise, do what you want with your money. Buy other lenses. Who knows? Either way, I hope you've had a really nice day, and I am sure I will be posting soon about other tat that you can buy on eBay.
Let's disappear without goodbyes and say we've gone mad and lost our minds. Oh, who cares? It's true. Madly in love with you. Madly in love with you.